Ever wondered why bananas don't turn black in the market but do so quickly at home? It's a curiosity we've all experienced. You bring home a bunch of bananas, all vibrant and yellow, only to find them turning black within a day or two. Yet the bananas at the market remain perpetually yellow, as if freshly plucked from the tree. This isn't a phenomenon exclusive to bananas, mind you. It applies to most fruits and vegetables. They stay fresh in the market, but the moment they enter our homes, they seem to spoil at an accelerated pace. So what's the secret? What are the market vendors doing to keep their fruits and vegetables fresh, and can we replicate it at home? The answer lies in understanding what causes fruits and vegetables to spoil in the first place, and the culprit is something called ethylene gas. Let's unravel the mystery of why fruits remain fresh at the market but spoil quickly at home. The secret behind fruit spoilage lies in a gas called ethylene. Now let's delve deeper into the science behind this. You see, ethylene is a naturally occurring gas that is produced by a variety of fruits and some vegetables at different stages of their development, right from when they're still green until they ripen. This gas is essentially the signal that tells a fruit it's time to mature. As fruits produce ethylene, it triggers enzymes within them to break down their cell walls. This breakdown is what causes fruits to soften, a key characteristic of ripening. So, when you bite into a ripe apple and enjoy its juicy crunch, you can thank ethylene for that delightful experience. But the role of ethylene doesn't stop there. It continues to be emitted even after the fruit has softened and ripened. As more and more ethylene is produced, the fruit continues to mature. At the same time, the outer cover of the fruit begins to soften excessively, losing its protective abilities. This process doesn't end until the fruit becomes overripe and begins to spoil. So while ethylene is essential for ripening, it's also responsible for the inevitable overripening and spoilage if left unchecked. Interestingly, not all fruits respond to ethylene in the same way. Some, like apples, watermelons, peaches, kiwis, and bananas, produce it in large quantities, while others, like pineapples, grapes, and citrus fruits, produce it in smaller amounts. Ethylene gas, therefore, plays a crucial role in fruit ripening and eventual spoilage. So, how does this science explain the freshness of fruits in the market? Well, let's dive right in. Markets have a secret weapon in their arsenal. Ethylene control. By managing the levels of this gas, they can effectively slow down the ripening process, keeping the fruits fresh and vibrant for longer. Take a moment to picture this, a bustling market filled with a vibrant array of fruits. Among them, we find a group called climacteric fruits, including apples, peaches, and our friend, the banana. These fruits are unique in that they produce large amounts of ethylene, continuing to ripen even after they've been plucked from the tree. It's like they have their own little ripening engine running inside them. Now contrast this with another group, the non-climacteric fruits, such as pineapples and oranges. These fruits are a bit more laid back. They produce less ethylene, and once they're picked, they say, "That's it, I'm done growing." But if they come into contact with external ethylene, they'll continue ripening. Markets use this knowledge to their advantage, separating these two groups and carefully controlling their environments to slow down the ripening process. It's a fine balancing act of nature and science, all in the pursuit of market freshness. Understanding the science behind ethylene production and fruit ripening can help us keep our fruits fresh for longer at home. So, you see, selling bananas isn't just about selling bananas. It's about understanding the science of ethylene gas, managing stock, and playing the ripening game just right. And that, my friends, is the secret life of bananas. It's all about timing and understanding the science of ethylene gas.